Good evening. I am Jane Rideout. I'm one of the co-lead pastors here at St. Andrew's along with my husband Gary. And we want to welcome you. Whether you are at home watching or here in the sanctuary, we want to welcome you to this Good Friday service. Will you join me for the call to worship? Fear and fascination drew observers to the first Good Friday, and these emotions have attracted people ever since. We cannot flee from the pain and suffering which Jesus experienced on our behalf. We wonder why one so faithful and loving had to face the agony of rejection and death. Jesus was wounded for our transgressions and was bruised for iniquities. In this time of worship, we join Christ at Calvary, aware of our own involvement in the cruelty that is present there. Our faithfulness is tested at the cross, and our lives are judged by our response. Will you join me for this unison prayer? O merciful God, you did not spare your only Son, but offered him up for us all, that he might bear our sins upon the cross. Grant that we might examine our lives and recognize the things that we do that would crucify him anew. Help us to recognize those nails which we drive into his cross today, and transform us into faithful disciples in his name. Amen.
Thank you. a reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 23, verses 33 through 34. When they came to a place called the Skull, they nailed him to the cross, and the criminals were also crucified, one on his right and one on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." And now join me in the reading. O God, help us consider our pride and the blindness it causes. Do not let us deceive ourselves. Our pride hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know our pride hurts you too.
I'm reading from Luke 23, 39 through 43. One of the criminals hanging next to him scoffed. "So you're the Messiah, are you? Prove it by saving yourself and us too while you're at it." But the other criminal protested, "Don't you fear God even when you have been sentenced to die? We deserve to die for our crimes, but this man hasn't done anything wrong." And then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus replied, "I assure you, today you'll be with me in paradise." Oh God, help us to consider how we betray others, how we abandon them in a time of need, how we think of ourselves first. Do not let us deceive ourselves. Our acts of betrayal hurt us and create walls between us and others. Oh God, we know our betrayal hurts you too.
Thank you. This reading comes from John 19, verses 25 through 27. Standing near the cross were Jesus' mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother standing there beside the disciple that he loved, he said to her, "Dear woman, here is your son." And he said to his disciple, "Here is your mother." And from then on, this disciple took her into his own home. O Lord, help us to consider how we envy others, how we desire more than what we receive, and seek to influence and rule over others. Do not let us deceive ourselves. Our envy hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know our envy hurts you too.
From the Gospel of Mark, chapter 15, verses 33 through 34. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land until 3 o'clock. Then at 3 o'clock, Jesus called out in a loud voice, Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you abandoned me? Oh God, help us to consider how we waver, how we seek to avoid responsibility, to blame others for our actions. Do not let us deceive ourselves. Between us and others. Oh God, we know our indecision hurts you too.
A reading from John 19:28. Jesus knew that his mission was now finished, and to fulfill Scripture, he said, I am thirsty. Oh God, help us to consider how we are cruel to others, how we malign and slander others, and add to the evil that comes upon them. Do not let us deceive ourselves. Our acts of cruelty hurt us and create walls between us and others. Oh God, we know our cruelty hurts you too.
Our sixth word comes from John chapter 19, verse 29 and 30. A jar of sour wine was sitting there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put it on a hyssop branch, and held it up to his lips. When Jesus had tasted it, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and released his spirit. Oh God, help us to consider the prejudice we show to others, how we fail to care and make distinctions among them. Do not let us deceive ourselves. Our acts of prejudice hurt us and create walls between us and others. Oh God, we know our prejudice hurts you too.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us now and in our final hour.
Jesus is the way.
From the Gospel of Luke, chapter 23, verse 46. Then Jesus shouted, "Father, I entrust my spirit into your hands." And with those words, he breathed his last. And suddenly the curtain of the temple was torn in two from the top to the bottom. The earth shook and the rocks were split. Even the tombs of the dead were open. Now when a centurion on watch and all the others who were with him saw all that was taking place, they were filled with awe and said, "This man truly was God's royal son."
A reading from Isaiah 53, 4 through 9. Yet it was our weaknesses he carried. It was our sorrows that weighed him down. And we thought his troubles were a punishment from God, a punishment of his own sins. But he was pierced for our rebellion, crushed for our sins. He was beaten so that we could be whole. He was whipped so that we could be healed. All of us, like sheep, have strayed away. We have left God's path to follow our own way. Yet the Lord laid on him the sins of all of us. He was oppressed and treated harshly, yet he never said a word. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter. And as a sheep is silent before the shearers, he did not open his mouth. Unjustly condemned, he was led away. No one cared that he died without descendants, that his life was cut short in midstream. But he was struck down for the rebellion of my people. He had done no wrong and had never deceived anyone, but he was buried like a criminal. He was put in a rich man's grave.
Please now leave in silence.